You guys are gonna wanna see this video. Takahashi 102 TSA against the SV Boney 102. Let's get to it. Okay, guys, welcome back to the Joe Jaguar Show. One more time, your best friend in astronomy, science, and telescopes. I thought I'd do this video. Now, I know some of you are gonna say this is unfair video because a Takahashi 102 TSA triplet ED, this sucker is no longer in production, but in Canada, when they were made, I believe, don't quote me 100%, I think it was about $4,500, around there. $4,500 to, I don't know, $4,800, somewhere around there. Now, this guy is also a 102, so they are exactly the same size. This is F8, F7, okay? But this is a lower entry ED with a 51 glass, and this is a doublet. And not even with the high grade 53 lens, this is with a lower grade 51 lens. And this is a triplet with the 53 expensive lens. So this is about as good as you're gonna get in a 4-inch. In 2019, I have also compared this guy to the EvoStar 100. And I found there was a huge difference in there. A couple of you have said, maybe I got a bad sample in the EvoStar. That could be. However, like anybody or everybody that does their testing, I can't literally test or, you know, buy 30 of them, see which one is the best, and then test it against another one. And nor would it be fair if I, because then I would have to buy 20 or 30 of these, see which one's perfect, and then you do a match type of thing. But this is where quality control comes in, where some of the higher name brands and the medium high brands and the medium brands and whatever is they got more quality control. So maybe I did get a bad Skywatcher 100, but it is what it is. That's what I bought. That's what I tested. And I found it to be a huge difference. And the reason why in that video, not to jump to that one all the time, but why I kept on saying it was a huge difference, not a little difference, because as you guys know, when I do my testing, I always go low power. And a lot of times in my testing, low power, can't really tell, hardly anything. Medium power, sometimes I see a little. And then at the high power is where it starts to separate the lower mass produced stuff or even the medium grade produced stuff compared to the top stuff. Now remember too, an EvoStar, I think currently, and for the last several years, a 100 ED is about 1600 before tax. That's about 1800 Canadian. So that's not so cheap. That's only about, comparing to the price of this, about half. Now, if we compare this to here, you're literally talking close to minimum 8 times to almost 10 times the price difference. So that's a huge difference in price. So, but anyway, you know, sometimes I like to do these videos of, you know, they're the same size. They are, you know, even though it's a doublet and this is a triplet, this is a low level doublet. This is an extreme high quality triplet. They're both the same size. And I want to see if there's any difference. Now, there's no planets out right now. So we'll probably just do a star test on whatever star we find and maybe the first quarter moon coming up in about a week and a half type of thing. So we'll try it on that. I really prefer to do it on the planets more, but they're not around. So I'm not gonna wait another minimum 3 months, I would say, 3.5 months. And cause I'm probably gonna have to give this guy back. So while I have it, and while these guys are literally the same size, let's just see how it goes. And what do I see? Any difference, big difference, medium difference, little difference, and we'll talk about it. So anyway, that video, I currently don't know, haven't decided, haven't made it yet, if it's going to go on the regular channel or it's going to go on the members channel. But if it does, you know, I've had a couple people when I did the show off between when I did the SV Boney 80mm ED against the Skywatcher Equinox and I did the comparison inside or the overview inside and then I did the final testing outside and it was only a members video. A couple people got upset saying thanks for nothing. But you know what? I have members videos and I have members, Patreon members that is, and they pay actually. So I have to make videos for that as well. Now, again, I've made it as cheap as I can go, like 99 cents a month. So, you know, I put one video up there once a month and I put your name in the description. You don't have to, but I do have to put things up there or there's no point having a members channel, right? So just saying, I don't know yet if I'm gonna make that one or the show off between these two on the members or the main channel, but it's still to be determined. But anyway, if you guys would like to join that channel, I'll put it up there, how to join. It's only 99 cents once a month. I'll put your name in the description. And that's really it for here. If you know anybody getting in the hobby, share my channel with them. If you're on the forums and maybe somebody wants to see a comparison like this type of thing, share my channel if you don't mind. And again, why not you? Why not me?